Worship you, we exalt you, we glorify you, we magnify you, O Lord. You are the King of kings and Lord of lords. You are the only God. You are the true God. You are the Savior. You are the light of the world. We thank you and praise you. Thank you for giving us this wonderful time and day, O Lord, that we are able to worship you. Thank you for the spirit which you have given us, O Lord, to worship you, to glorify your holy name, to thank you from the bottom of our hearts, O Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. All the glory, honor unto you. You are the Word. You are the living Word. You have the living words. Please speak to us, O Lord. Let your Word bring life to each and every one. Let your Word penetrate into the hearts and minds of the people, O God. Transform them, refine them, revive them, and review them, O God. And, O Lord, renew their lives, O Lord Jesus. And let your mighty name be glorified and be magnified. Let our bodies be transformed into your lowly body, O Lord Jesus, and we give us thy humbleness, give us the knowledge of your salvation, knowledge of your word, knowledge of your will, knowledge of your truth, O God, and help us to walk as your lights in this dark world. Bring us into your light, O Lord Jesus. Help us to comprehend the light of your word, and let your name be magnified and be glorified. Thank you for leading us through your Holy Spirit. In the same way, lead us through your Holy Spirit in speaking to each and every one. Persuade them by your word, O Lord Jesus, so that they will turn unto you and glorify your holy name, to receive your salvation, to receive your blessing, to receive your healing, to receive your deliverance, to receive all your strength and power in their lives, O God. And all glory and honor unto you. Please, please let your spirit dwell in the midst of us. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All of you just raise your hands and say a big hallelujah to our living God and our true God. And I greet you in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ, who has saved our lives, who has been protecting our lives, and also giving us his blessings through this crisis of corona. And also God has been our strength, our power, and all our life. My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, hope you are doing well. And we hope and pray that you also lead a spiritual and godly life, as it is very important, as the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ is very near, so we have to be prepared. He's coming. We do not know at what time, but God says that it will be like the thief in the night, so we have to be prepared at any time. So you have to meditate upon the word of God, pray in his presence, worship him in spirit and truth, and lay aside each and every sin which easily entices us, so that we can sacrifice our bodies as a living sacrifice to our living God, which is a due service which we have to do to him. So my dear children of God, as we are going to meditate upon the word of God, I encourage you to prepare your hearts and make yourself be available to hear the word of God. Lay aside all the works, don't concentrate upon anything, but focus your mind upon hearing the word of God. As the Bible says in the book of Acts chapter 16, that a woman called Lydia in the city of Philippi, she was hearing the words of Paul. So as she was hearing very keenly, and his interest was upon the words of spoken by Saint Paul, so God has opened her heart, and God has filled her heart with the words of God and given salvation to her and to her household. So we have to be very careful. We have to be cautious in hearing the word of God. We have to focus our minds and set our minds to hear the word of God very carefully, so that the word of God will be filling our hearts and minds, so that we can walk in his ways. My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, today for our meditation we'll be looking into the word of God from the epistle of Romans chapter 8 and verse 15. Paul has written this epistle to Romans. So the epistle to the Romans by Paul, chapter 8 and verse 15. For you did not receive the spirit of bondage again to fear,
but you received
the spirit of adoption,
by whom
we cry out, Abba, Father. See, the Bible says that we did not receive the spirit of bondage. Israelites were having the spirit of bondage when they were living in Egypt. For 430 years they were bond servants in Egypt, and they were having the spirit of bondage. Spirit of bondage was calling Pharaoh as Lord, as King. So they have to call Pharaoh as Pharaoh because he was the Lord of that country. So like that, for 430 years they were calling upon Pharaoh as Lord, and they could not call upon the name of God, but because they did not know the name of God. Just they were calling God of Abraham, Isaac and Jacob. So like that, they were calling the name of God and they were praying. So after that, when God has appeared to them on Mount Sinai, God has manifested his power and strength, and he has revealed his name to Moses, that is Jehovah, that is I am that I am. So God, in this way, he has revealed his name to them, and from that time they were calling as Jehovah, as Lord, as they were calling Adonai. So like that, God, they were calling upon the name of God and they were praying to God. But after many years, Jesus, after coming into this world, has taught a special prayer where we can call our God as a Father, that intimate relationship with God and ourselves, so that we can freely go into the presence of God and call him as our Father and pray to him and cry unto him and say our request to him, and we ask him whatever we need in our lives. So like that, that relationship Jesus has taught in his prayer. We can see the gospel according to Mark chapter 14 and verse 36, where Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane was praying to God when he was about to be arrested in the Garden of Gethsemane. So here Jesus was praying very fervently in the Garden of Gethsemane, calling upon God, saying that Abba Father. See, we can read the words. Gospel according to Mark chapter 14 and verse 36. And he said,
Abba Father,
all that are possible,
take this cup away from me.
Take this cup away from me. Nevertheless,
not
what
I will,
but what thou will. So here God is saying that Abba Father, and crying out to the Lord and King, the creator of the heavens and the earth. See, that intimate relationship with the Father Jesus had, he's showing the same relationship that we also should maintain in our lives. Because Israelites were not allowed to go into the presence of God. They used to fear to enter into the presence of God. They had that fear because it may happen that we may die in the presence of God. So they could not dare to enter into the presence of God. Even Moses, who was called by God, could not enter into the presence of God. He could not stay in the presence of God where God has appeared to him on Mount Sinai in the burning bush. So here, there, Moses was fearing. He covered his face. He could not look upon God. So much he has feared. He could not call upon God. So that's such a fear Israelites had to enter into the presence of God. Even Abraham, who was friend of God, feared very much to call upon God while he was seeking the salvation of Sodom and Gomorrah. While he was praying and asking God, Lord, save Sodom and Gomorrah. If 50 righteous people are found in Sodom and Gomorrah, do you destroy the righteous with the wicked people? So he was praying to God, asking God that you save Sodom and Gomorrah. So like that, but when God was accepting his prayers, again he was saying, I am like a dust. Lord, let me speak one more word to you. Like that, he was requesting to God. He was very much fearful in the presence of God in asking whatever he needed, my dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ. He was friend of God, but still he was fearing to ask God. So such was the fear, such was their adoration to God, and such was their respect and reverence to God, my dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ. So all those years people were fearing. Also, we can read one more verse in the book of Numbers, where Israelites, when they were standing in the presence of God, fire came from God and has
destroyed all the 250 people who were having censers in their hands and worshiping God. The book of Numbers, chapter 16. Verse 33.
So they and all those with them.
35.
And a fire came out
from the Lord and consumed the 250 men who were offering incense. See, 250 people, they were holding censers and frankincense in their censers, and they were offering to God, saying that we are also holy people, we can enter into the presence of God and we can worship Him. But God has given only to the household of Aaron to enter into the presence of God as a priest, so that he can do all the priestly works in that tabernacle. But the family of Korah, they were also interested, because we are also holy people, we can also enter into the presence of God, we are carrying the holy things of God, so we can also enter into the presence of God and worship Him and all, do all the priestly order in His tabernacle. But God has not permitted them, but God has given a gift and ordinances to the household of Aaron, only for his household to be priest forever in His presence, my dear children of God. So here, they themselves made that they are holy, and they were worshiping God. They were giving, offering incense to the living God. But fire came from the presence of God and kindled all of them and destroyed all of them, 250 people who were worshiping God and offering incense to Him. So the people were very fearful. Oh, we cannot enter into the presence of God. Who can enter into the presence of God? Such a fear was there in the lives of the people. We can see in chapter 17 and verse 13 also, where people were saying, who can come near the presence of God? The book of Numbers, chapter 17 and verse 13.
Whoever even comes near the tabernacle of the Lord must die.
Shall we all utterly die? See, such a fear. If we come to the presence of God, shall we die? So they were fearing to enter into the presence of God, to call upon the name of the Lord. Even prophet Elijah, he was very much fearful when he heard the voice of God. He covered his face with his mantle. So such was a fear to him, so that he could not look upon God, hear the voice of God. So all those people, they were unable to take the name of the Lord. In the Old Testament, the people, when they were writing the Bible, when they were writing the Old Testament, they used to, whenever they used to write the name of the Lord, first of all, they used to dip themselves in the water, completely take, bathe themselves with water, and then come and write the name of the Lord. And after that, again, they used to go and dip into the water, and they used to bathe and then come out. So such was that we are unholy, we cannot take the name of the Lord, we cannot write the name of the Lord, we cannot call the name of the Lord, because He was such a holy God that they could not call upon Him. They were fearing to call upon the name of the Lord, because God has given a commandment that you should not take the Lord, your God, name in vain. So they were fearful. Whoever takes the name of the Lord in vain, they used to be stoned and killed. So that's why people feared to take the name of the Lord and call upon Him to pray in His presence, my dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ. Here, Jesus has totally changed that attitude, has totally changed the relationship that men should have with God. What is the relationship with God and His people? How people should maintain the relationship with God? What is the relationship with the people and God? God has totally changed it. Jesus has taught us a new way to enter into His presence, in calling upon the name of the Lord, in praying to His name, my dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ. Because Jesus has totally had the fellowship with the Father. He used to hear from the Father, He used to love Him, and even the Father loved the Son. And Jesus always prayed freely to the Father. Our Heavenly Father is our prayer, my dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ. See, such a prayer God has taught. We can read in the Gospel according to Matthew, where Jesus is teaching us the prayer. So when we pray, how we ought to pray, Jesus has taught us a model prayer. Chapter 16 and verse 9.
In this manner,
therefore
pray.
Our Father in heaven. See, the calling upon the name of the God is our Father. See, as the child calls his father in the same loving way, in the same loving manner, in the same love, intimate relationship, in the same relationship, he is calling the God as our Father. So Jesus has taught this. So my dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, today, as they are celebrating Father's Day, so many people are saying, Happy Father's Day, Happy Father's Day, Happy Father's Day. But truly, do they love their fathers? So that we have to check today. So God is here, our Father. Jesus has loved the Father. Whatever the Father has said, he has done. He has done his will. He has done whatever he has said in his life. He never said no. Even the Father has never said no when Jesus asked anything in this life. Because whatever prayer Jesus prayed to God, his prayer was accepted. His prayer was answered. His prayer was always an yes before God. We can read in the Gospel according to John, where Jesus was praying before the tomb of Lazarus, praising God and asking God what he is saying in his prayer. Just we'll read. The Gospel according to John, chapter 11. Verse 41. Then they took away the stone from the place where the dead man was lying. And Jesus lifted up his eyes and said, Father, I thank you that you have heard me. And I know that you always hear me, but because of the people. See, thank you for you have heard me, and I know that you always hear me. See, always the Father hears his son. Always the Father hears his daughter. Always the Father hears what the son and daughter are saying to him, asking him, my dear children of God. Here, our Abba Father, why such a word is being used? Because Jesus has totally changed how the way in calling God, Abba Father. Because people were having the spirit of bondage. Whoever commits sin, he is a bond servant to sin. So here, we have been delivered from sin. We have been delivered from that bondage. We have been delivered from that devil, Satan, because we were in bondage. Satan has taken hold of our lives. But now, God is giving us a different spirit. The spirit of Jesus Christ. The spirit of Jesus, which has called the heavenly God as the Father, Abba Father. We can read in the epistle to Galatians, chapter 4 and verse 6.
And because of your sons.
Because your sons.
God has sent forth the spirit of his son.
God has sent forth the spirit of his son.
Into your heart.
Into your heart.
Crying out. Abba Father.
Abba Father. See, because you are sons, God has sent forth the spirit of his son. His son is Jesus Christ. God has sent forth his spirit. The spirit of Jesus Christ God has given us. Because Jesus could freely call upon God, Abba Father. Abba is an Aramaic word, the native language of Jesus Christ, where Jesus has spoken in Aramaic, he has preached gospel in Aramaic language, not Hebrew. Because only in Jerusalem and other people, some people were speaking Hebrew, but many of the people were speaking Aramaic language during those days. So here, Jesus was calling upon God. Ab means that is father in Hebrew. But Abba is an Aramaic word where it says father. But father has been added because it was used in Greek. So in two words, in two languages, it is like in Telugu we are calling Nana. In English as we call father or daddy or papa or whatever it may be. That loving relationship with which we have. So here Jesus is using the word for father in two languages, that is Aramaic language, and also he is using the language which he has learned, my dear brothers and sisters. So whatever language you may use, but the relationship is that he is our father. We can call him as our father, so that because father provides each and every need of his children. He takes care of his children. He will he will bless his children, because Isaac has blessed Jacob. In this way, the father Jacob has blessed his 12 sons while he was dying. So here God as our father is blessing God. He provides each and everything in our lives, my dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ. So here God has not given us the spirit of bondage. When we have the spirit of bondage, we cannot call upon God as father. But when God is giving the spirit of his son Jesus Christ, so that we are able to cry unto God, Abba Father. Usually children call when they fall down somewhere, or when they are in pain, they call Amma, that is mother. But they don't call, usually call father. But here Jesus never called Mary, Amma, mother, please help me. But Jesus has called always, my father, Abba Father, heavenly father, you have heard me. He cried unto him. When he was upon the cross, he was crying, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. He was crying to the Father. He was calling upon his God as Father. So here, Jesus, what he has taught to us, we have to learn in our lives, my dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ. So, Israelites were now being taught to call God as Abba Father, so that they can freely come into the presence of God, call upon his name and glorify his name and pray whatever request they have in their lives. So here, when we call God as our Father, so Father is the one who provides each and everything to us in this world. So the Father provides his blessings. He gives us whatever we need. He gives us food. He gives us dresses. He gives us provisions for our studies and all. Provides each and everything in this world, house or whatever it, vehicle or whatever articles are we need in this world. So here, our Heavenly Father is also providing everything to us. He is providing the sunlight, he is giving us the rain, he is giving the fruit of this earth so that our hearts are being made glad. And God, the Father is giving all the blessings which we need, especially he has given the salvation to us. So we can read one more word in the epistle written by James chapter 1. Where the Father of lights is giving us every good blessings from heaven. Chapter 1, verse 17.
Every good gift. And every perfect
gift.
Is from above.
And comes down.
From the Father of lights.
Every good gift, every perfect gift. See, Jesus has given us a very good parable. See, whenever a child asks his father, Lord, I want bread, he will not give a stone. When the son asks for a fish, the father does not give a snake. So here, though we are the fathers in this world being evil, when they are giving good deeds or good blessings, good food, good clothes, and whatever good they can provide in this life to them, they are giving very good, the best one they are giving. But how about our Heavenly Father? He will give very good gift and the perfect gift here to us. He has given perfect gift, that is gift of salvation he has given, gift of his Son, gift of his Holy Spirit, gifts of the Holy Spirit he has given to us. So like this, every perfect gift he has given to us, the Father of lights, my dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, with whom there is no variation of shadow of turning. So such a good father we have. So let us come to his throne and the throne of grace when he is eager to open his hand and bless the blessings which we can have, enjoy in this world. So my dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, here in closing, I want to remind you that do not forget the blessings of our Father, the goodness of our Father. So always we should remember his goodness, what gifts he has given to us in this world. We should never forget, because the Bible says that we should not forget all the benefits God has given to us. So he has given every good thing under the sun. He is giving the sunlight to us. He is giving the rain to us. He is giving the food to us. He is providing clothes to us and all the basic needs, whatever we have in this world. More than that also He is giving. Our vessels are being overflowed by His blessings. He is providing us ways to study, and He is giving us talents to be useful in this world. He is giving different things to be utilized by us for our comforts. So all these things God is giving us. And more than that, God has given His only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, for our salvation. That's why the Bible says that God has so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son. So God has given His only begotten Son for our salvation. So my dear brothers, sisters in Jesus Christ, such a salvation God has given, such a good gift God has given. So we should never forget the gift of salvation, the gift of the Holy Spirit, which has been given to us by our Father because of His goodness. Though we are not worthy for it, God has given us because He is a good Father, our Heavenly Father. We can come to His presence and call upon His name, Abba Father, and never forget His blessings. Then we should always remember His blessings. I want to remind you the parable of the prodigal son, where the prodigal son has taken his property, he has made into his money, and gone to a foreign country. There he wasted his money with all the prostitutes, and at last there was famine in that country. And at the time, he remembered his father. See, when he was coming to his father ran to him, opened his arms, and he hugged him and kissed him, say, "My son was dead, now he is alive." See, such a love Father shows to us, but never He expresses it. Though the Father bears all things in our lives, though He has been long-suffering towards us in many things, because from Adam to until now, God has been bearing all things, long-suffering to with each and every person, whatever sins or transgressions they have committed in their lives, He was long-suffering with all of them. Such a good Father we have, my dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ. So come to Him if you have transgressed or if you have committed any sin. Know His love, that the Father's love will never be changed. Not even a shadow of variation will be in His attitude towards us. Whenever we come to Him, whenever we call to Him, Abba Father, He will show His same love towards, His unchanging love towards us. Because when the child calls upon daddy, when the child says, though the father is very angry with the children, but when the child cries, "Daddy," all he forgets, all the anger which he had, all the tiredness which he had in his life, he will forget. And whatever the child needs, immediately he will be attending to the needs of the child. He will be showing his care, his love, and all things he will be providing to the children. So here, we should never forget the love of the Father. He has shown the love towards Jesus Christ. Whatever Jesus asked the Father, He has given it. He has given His beloved Son to us. So He will never withhold anything to give to us. And He has given the same position. He has adopted us to call Abba Father, means we are equally possessing or inheriting the kingdom of God as heirs with Jesus Christ. So God has made heirs with Jesus Christ. So you also remember His love, how He has shown His love towards us, and turn to Him and live in His love and never love this world. Because the Bible says that if you love this world, the love of the Father will not be in their hearts. We can read the letter written by John, first letter, chapter 2, and we'll close. Verse 15.
Do not love the world.
Or the things in the world.
If anyone loves the world,
the love of the Father is not in him. See. Do not love the world or the things of the world. When you love this world and the things of this world,
the love of the Father you will be losing in your life. So never lose the love of the Father, because you can never again get the love of the Father. See, my dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, Esau, when he had lost the love of his father Isaac, the blessing of his father, never again he could get that blessing in his life. So never lose that love, that relationship with the Father you have. Maintain that relationship, maintain that love, maintain his obedience, give that reverence to him, and in the same time obey whatever the Father says to you, because always the Father wants his children to be in a high position, because God intended Adam and Eve to possess this world and to possess the things in heaven, but they failed in their life because they have eaten the forbidden fruit. But Jesus possessed his blessings in this world and has possessed all things that are in heaven, and he has sat at the right hand of the Father, and he has received all the glory which he had before. Even God wants to give us that same glory. He wants to fill us with his glory, with his blessings, with his God wants to give us in our lives, he wanted to give in heaven also. So that's why never lose the blessings of the Father, never hurt the Heavenly Father, never hurt your Father, but always respect him, love him, abide in him, in his love, and obey his word, listen to him. If you walk in his ways, definitely the Father of lights will give you the perfect and good gift in your life. Let us pray. Bow down your heads, kneel down if it is okay with you. If you don't have any knee problems or any health problems, you can kneel down, raise up your hands and ask God, Abba Father. Let's cry to God, Abba Father. Abba Father, we thank you. Abba Father, we thank you for giving us your beloved Son Jesus Christ. Abba Father, thank you for giving us perfect gifts. Abba Father, thank you for giving us all the perfect gifts in our lives, oh God. Thank you. Thank you, Abba Father. Thank you, Abba Father, for giving us your wisdom. Thank you for your salvation. Thank you for your knowledge. Thank you for the food which you have given us. Thank you for the clothing which you have given us. Thank you for the wisdom which you have given us. Thank you for the studies which you have given us, O Lord. Thank you for all the comforts which you have given us in this world. And thank you for all the needs which you have met us, O God. Thank you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Abba Father. Thank you, Abba Father. We glorify you. We glorify you. We glorify you. Let us sing that song, Our Father in Heaven. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We'll sing that song.
Thank you.
So as this song is sung, you can offer your offerings. You can transfer by Google Pay, Phone Pay, or net banking. You thank the Lord with your voices. You thank the Lord by giving him your offerings. You thank the Lord from the bottom of your heart. Lord, thank you for giving me all things in my life. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Abba Father.
You, Lord, I just want to thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I just want to thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Him, Abba Father, we thank you, Lord, for hearing our prayers. Thank you for giving me good health. Thank you for healing me. Thank you for delivering me. Thank you for saving my life, oh God. Thank you for saving my life from all perils, oh God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for your sanctification. Thank you for cleansing me from all my sins and transgressions.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, we thank you. Thank you for saving our lives, oh Lord. Thank you for cleansing us from every transgression and sin, every abomination we have committed, oh Lord. Thank you for your deliverance from all Satan forces, all forces of darkness, oh Lord. Thank you for the cross of Calvary, oh Lord. Thank you for your sacrificial blood, oh Lord. Thank you for your forgiveness which you have given us, O Lord. Thank you for your long suffering. Thank you for your righteousness, O Lord. Thank you for the power of your Holy Spirit, O God. Thank you for the gifts of the Holy Spirit which you have given us. Thank you for all the good gifts and perfect gifts which you have given us, O Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Abba, Father, we thank you for the every good gift and perfect gift which you have given us in our life, O Lord. There is no variation in you, even shadow, O Lord Jesus. We thank you. Thank you for giving us good blessings, O Lord. Thank you for each and every good gift which you have given our lives, O Lord. We can just thank you, Lord, for all the things which you have done. Thank you for the salvation. Thank you for your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. Thank you for the sacrificial blood. Thank you for the forgiveness. Thank you for the long suffering which you have towards us, O Lord. Thank you for your unconditional love which you have shown to us, O Lord Jesus. Thank you, thank you, thank you for all the things which you have bestowed upon us, O God. We never forget the good things which you have given to us, O Lord, but we thank you for each and everything which you have given in our lives. At this time, I pray for all the people who have given offerings for the ministry, for the construction of the church, O Lord. Bless them, open the treasures of heaven, open the doors of heaven, and bless them right now in your mighty name, O God. Let their vessels be filled and overflow with your blessings, O God. You are the one who blesses us, O God. You are the one who provides each and everything to us, O Lord. You are the one who takes care of our lives, O Lord. Please, Heavenly Father, give each and everything the request of you, O Lord. As your word says that ask, we ask in your name, O Lord. We seek in your presence. We knock at your door, O Lord, because you are our Father. We come to your presence and say, Abba, Father, we need this, O God. Give to them whatever they need in their life. Deliver them from each and every power of darkness, O Lord. Powers of Satan, O Lord. Be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Be trampled in the mighty name of Jesus, O God. All glory and honor unto you. Pour out your Holy Spirit right now, O Lord. Lord, open heavens and let your Spirit come down upon each and everyone. Oh Lord, Holy Spirit, come upon everyone. Come upon everyone. Come upon everyone right now. Rishandarava, Rikarasyalarava, Anirambarasyalarava, Oh Rikarasyalarasyalarava, Sikharabarava. Lord, Heavenly Father, I pray whoever are suffering with diseases, oh Lord, illness, sickness, and corona, right now, in your mighty name, heal them, O Lord. O Lord Jesus, heal them by your wounded hand, O God. Heal them by your stripes, O God. Heal them by the blood which you have sacrificed upon the cross of Calvary. Right now, let your blood be sprinkled upon them. Heal from every sickness, every disease, every weakness. Be gone from their bodies and strengthen their bodies, O God. Renew them, O God. Let your mighty name be glorified. And give them thy peace and joy in their hearts. Give them the light, O God. Bring them into your light and make them walk in your light, O God. And answer their prayers. Grant their petitions, O God. Whatever their need in this world, let your blessings come upon them. Provide them houses. Provide them children. And give them all the good gifts and perfect gifts which they need in their lives for your salvation and for you be prepared so that they'll be prepared for your second coming. All the spiritual gifts be bestowed upon them
to lead a godly life in your presence and read your word, pray in your presence, glorify, exalt and praise your holy name and worship and show reverence to your holy name and bow their knee before you and call upon your holy name in reverence, O God. Let your mighty name be glorified. We ask all this as we also thank you for giving us and hearing our prayers, O Lord. In the blessed name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. 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 Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name.